the president of the Association of Filipino Franchisers back in 2015 and 2016. And I've been featured, fortunate enough, in some magazines. But before all of this, as you know, I'm just a simple boy. Sabi ko na akin yung para-uma. So, halimbawa sa Naga, came from a modest family. And as you know, my mother was a teacher here at Ateneo, and my father was a government employee. And ever since I was a kid, I always dreamt of being rich. So, inisip ko, paano kayo mabuhay ng may magarang sasakyan or kaya may malaking bahay. So, when I graduated in college, I was fortunate enough to be hired by Procter & Gamble. And from then on, I started doing business on the side. So, I started a boutique shop in Centro, then proceeded with a mobile car wash in LCC, and then eventually, a weekend restaurant back there in Isaro, which is, I think, mga 10 years earlier. But after failing in these three business attempts, I realized na yun, it took a big hit on myself, on my confidence level. So I was asking myself, bobo ba ako? Ba't hindi ko makuha maging successful sa isang negosyo? But then, after 1 year, I saw this product that can save up to 96% on printing costs. And sabi ko, this is it. So I called up my mom and sabi ko sa kanya, Ma, eto na. Alam ko na yung magpapayaman sa atin. And alam ko yung sabi niya sa akin. Sabi niya, anak, magkano naman kaya ang malibugin mo dyan? And hindi ko alam kung joke siya, but I can sense the concern in her voice because I feel not once, not twice, but 3 times a day. And in the process, you know, I've lost 1 million pesos. And then sabi ko na lang sa kanya, Ma, masasalbat, matamahan ko rin yan. And I was so happy that King Kong Yuken was born in 2005. And from then on, sunod-sunod na yung paglaki ni King Kong Yuken. And I was also so happy that I did not give up. Otherwise, I won't be here talking with you today. But enough about me, let's talk about secret number one, which is the number one killer of first-time entrepreneurs and how to avoid it. I want to ask you this, is there a difference between letter A, 1 times 1 million pesos, and then letter B, 1 million times 1 peso? Tingin nyo, may difference ba? Sino nagsabi meron? Wala. Sino nagsabi wala? Meron. Okay. Sino nagsabi, kahit anong sabihin ko, walang tataas ang kamay. Okay, so, in man, both products, di ba, are 1 million pesos. So there's no difference. But actually in business, there's a huge difference. Okay? Let me explain why. So the first column is the number of practice. And then the second column is the investment per practice. So what do I mean? Assuming you have 1 million pesos. So in letter A, you invest all your money, the 1 million pesos, in one business. Okay? So letter B naman, you invest 1 million times, you practice 1 million times, and piso lang yung investment. Now, we have to realize that most of us were not trained to become entrepreneurs. Diba? We were trained to be employees. We were taught in school to be how to be good employees so that when we graduate, we can find a decent job. Now, eventually, when we start to ask, when we decide to start our own business, it's very unlikely that you will get it the first time. Okay? You need to practice and practice and practice until you hit it right. And for me, somehow I practiced 3 times, lost 333,000 on the average for each practice. It's just like going to school, di ba? Meron kang first year, second year, third year, and fourth year before you graduate in college. So it's all about practice. Sabi ni Bruce Lee, paborito natin to. Di ba? I fear not the man who practiced 10,000 kicks once, but I fear the man who practiced one kick 10,000 times. And unfortunately, for the mindset of first-time entrepreneurs, di ba, they think that they can get it right the first time. So what do? They have 1 million pesos that they they've saved for 10 years. They invest all their money in the first business. Tapos since first business nila, most likely they will fail. And then what will happen? Tumanga na. Diba wala na pang second practice? Because naubos na sa first practice pala. And that's the number one killer of first-time entrepreneurs, that is spending too much in their first business. Okay? Because I want you to remember this. This is very important. The goal of the first business is not actually to earn millions of pesos. The goal of the first business is not to earn millions of pesos, but rather to learn. So you need to spend as little as possible on your first business so that you can practice. And eventually, masusustain mo yun, and if you practice and practice, you will hit it right eventually. You might be asking me, how little is little? So can you guess, I shared with you that I lost 1 million in my first few businesses. Can anyone guess how much I invested in equipment? Karan ba? 200,000? Lower? 50? Lower? 10,000 pesos. And that 10,000 pesos enabled me to recover my 1 million losses in the first few businesses. And hindi lang ako yun. I interviewed many other entrepreneurs. They also started with 10,000 pesos. And that goes to show that you don't need a lot of money to start your own successful business. Alright? So that's the first secret, the number one killer of first-time entrepreneurs, and that is spending too much in your first business. Okay? So dapat you need to spend as little as possible and just practice, keep on practicing. So let's move on to secret number two, which is the most damaging mistake of new entrepreneurs and how to bypass it. When I was starting my business back in early 2000, I saw this article from John Bokumbay. He shared how he became successful in business. And one line there really caught my attention. And ito yun. Sabi niya, I saw that in 1961 now, I saw that what multinational companies are doing, they are branding their products. And ang ginawa niya, kinopya niya yun and applied it to his business. And we all know how successful John Bokumbay's businesses are. Diba? So it's all about branding. And alam natin that branding starts with a unique and memorable name. So if you want to build a long-term business, you have to have a good brand. So question sa inyo, do you agree with this that you should put what you are selling in your brand name to let people know what your brand is all about? So kung nagtitinda ka ng siomay, dapat ba yung brand name mo ay siomay? Kung nagtitinda ka ng lugaw, dapat ba yung brand name mo may lugaw? Sino nag-agree? Sino hindi? Sino nagsasabi? Kahit ano sa tingin ko dito, hindi kayo magtataas ng tawa. Okay. So, do you agree with this? Somehow, yes. Okay. I'll share with you my experience. When I was starting Equal, okay, ito rin yung natatandaan ko. Okay? So, I'm starting a name business. So, I talk about brand name that somehow my name. So, came up with Equal, you can. Parang catchy siya. Okay? Natuwa ka nun. And then, lumabas ang mga competitors ko. So, nandiyan si Ingrid, si Ingboy, si Ingplaza, si Ingforles, si Ingman. And suddenly, dito na. Okay? Lahat kami may Ing. Okay? In fact, I have an entrepreneur friend, one time nasa stage kami. And then, he called me, sabi niya, Jerry daw of Ingforles. Sabi ko, sa lolo, Ingman yung nga, hindi Ingforles. Diba? And hindi lang yun. Okay? Meron din tumawag sa akin, Jerry daw of Ink All The Way. Sabi ko, parang Christmas na lang, Jerry All The Way. Parang adults pa, medyo ibang So, Ink All The Way. And that's because we were using ink, and that's so confusing. Okay? Now, I know most of you have tried Shomai. But when you go to the mall, very prominent yun. Maraming Shomai cards. But do you remember the Shomai brand that you tried? Is it Pastor Shomai, Shomai House, Shomai King, or Shomai Central? Medyo mahirap, no? Kasi lahat sila siomay. Okay? Another example, we were trying this when we were in, or still in parokyan, di ba? Scramble. Sumikat yun, late 2000. Pero natatandaan mo ba yung brand? Is that Manila Scramble, Pinoy Scramble, Scramble Rumble, Scramble Avenue, or Ice Cream Scramble? Lahat sila pink and lahat sila may scramble. Lito-lito na. Okay? And that's the most damaging mistake you can do as an entrepreneur. That is putting generic words for what you are selling in your branding. Because we all know that brand name is the foundation of marketing. Diba? But many of us don't realize that you cannot trademark a generic name. When I applied for trademark, okay, intellectual property office, pinadisclaim sa akin yung ink, pinadisclaim sa akin yung all you can. Wala nang natira. Okay? And also, it's very hard and expensive to change a brand name. Okay? So, how do you bypass this? First and foremost, when you think of a brand name, dapat, it's not generic. It should be unique. So, wala dyan ink, wala dyan shomai. And ideally, it should contain 2 to 3 syllables only. Why? Because we have to realize lahat tayo naman. Okay? We don't say that I invested in a condominium. Aba na na, condominium. 4 syllables yun. So what do we say? I live in a condo. Sinortcut na natin. Even nga si McDonald's, sinortcut pa natin McDo. So if you don't want to customers to murder your branding, dapat 2 to 3 syllables na. And ideally, it should be available in the intellectual property office. Ayaw natin ang ganito. Ano yung nakikita mo dyan? Ito, di ba? Wala kang magagawa, kakasuhan ka dyan, papalitan mo din lang yan. So do it right the first time. So, this is my question. Do you agree that you should put what you are selling in your branding? Sana I convince you na that's the most damaging mistake that you can do as an entrepreneur. So, we're done with the number one killer first-time entrepreneurs, and ano yun? That is spending too much on your first business. And second is the most damaging mistake of new entrepreneurs, and that is putting generic words for what you are selling in your branding. So we're down to the last one, the number one reason why most people give up and how to control it. Now, I'm going to share with you this true story about motivation. So, in a sales convention, the sales director deployed the sales targets for the year. That's a salesperson. And then, he asked everyone to write on a piece of paper why they want to reach their sales quota. And alam naman natin, di ba, when a salesperson reached their sales quota, what do they get? Incentives. Diba? So, people write their individual results and then pass it to the sales director. Then after 12 months, the results were given. And then the sales director was curious. Was there a correlation between the results they put 12 months ago to the results of the performance for the year? And you know what he found out? The people who have the most compelling results stated 12 months ago are also happen to be the top performers. In fact, when you look at the top 10 performers, their reasons why are the most compelling ones. And so that means that if the salesperson said that he wanted to reach the sales quota because his boss said so, he achieved a certain level of success. But if the salesperson has a deeper reason, his results are higher. In fact, when you look at the top, the number one performer, you know what his reason was? He needed the money to pay for the hospital bill of his sick mother. And that's the reason why he worked so hard throughout the year to achieve the results that he wanted. So my question for you is, if you want to become an entrepreneur, why do you want to become an entrepreneur? And that reason should be compelling enough to motivate you to wake up early in the morning and then work on your business. Tapos kahit na weekends, for good happy hours, work on your business din. You know why? Because most people give up on their dream because they don't want it enough. Okay? So you have to have the compelling reason why you want to become an entrepreneur. And I share this to my entrepreneur members. I call it the "This is why" template. So you put there the sample reasons. So for example, for this one, with my business, I can send my two kids to the best private schools even though I did not finish college. And then, sample deadline, put there, and then you sign it. And this is one of my students as well, who is now successful, he filled that up. So, I want you to write why you want to become an entrepreneur. And then, post it in at least three areas that you will see every single day. Post it in your bedroom, in your bathroom, in your desk. Some people use it as wallpaper. In their desktop and their laptops. You know why? Ask me. Why? Because when you start your business, and nahihirapan ka, sasaktan, nawawala ng pag-asa, hopefully you will see that reason why, and it will remind you why you are doing it in the first place. And hopefully, that reason should serve as your vitamins to keep moving forward and to never, ever give up. So, we talk about the number one killer of first-time entrepreneurs, and that is spending too much in your first business. Dapat you spend as little as possible. And then, the last one, the most damaging mistake of new entrepreneurs, and that is putting generic words for what you are selling in your brand name. And then lastly, the number one reason why most people give up and how to control it. And that is, you have people don't want it bad enough. So you have to have that compelling reason why. When I was resigning from my work in PNG, during the disability, people asked me, is it worth it? Why do you want to forgo the corporate career and then work as an entrepreneur, which is full of risks? Well, if you're passionate about being an entrepreneur and you're happy seeing people using your products, then by all means, right, it's all worth it. And as a jackpot, when you hit the jackpot, you earn way much more than you can as an employee. And then I told them, I feel happy when I see someone eat three times a day because of my business. And now I'm so glad that I'm not just helping one person, not just 10, but over 100 employees eating three times a day because of my business. Is it worth it? It is. So thank you very much for your business. Thank you very much, everyone.
Masaya na rin kung actually my previous industries, politika, wala na talagang problema yung mga slide talaga. Kaya kung naman po ka, tuloy po ko na ka, doon magtaraman na slide. Anyway po, magusto mo po ako si Noli San Luis. Very lucky akong magkaiba yung mga kabasya matitiba. Yan si Jerry, yan si Noli, yan si Bosnato, tapos po. Sabi mo kasi mga kanya po, si batch na maganda ko, kumpletong maray. Ano, iguan na kaming kabatch na lalaki, babae na muna. Totoo po yan. Sisay ang batch na ko, kaya kabilang po. Ako po, I was not raised to become a mayor. I was not raised to become a leader. In fact, kang elementary and high school ako, aram ni kagabos na batch na pinbilang ako nasa gili. On the sideline. I've never been involved in sports, so school politics, my book. But when I started going to college in Los Banos, pandemic naga, that is when I decided to be a change team. Kapag dumanggo ko sa Los Banos, nag-ibisama ko ako sa clubs ka to. In fact, nagka-club kami ni Noli. We became leaders of our clubs, UP Bukos. That was my training club. Dito po nasa yung area ko, ang aktivista, siyempre, mapunagod sa sabuya ka kasi sarili mo. Sa nasabay ako, sabi niya, ano ngayon makukuha ko dyan sa pag-aractivista mo? Na-aktivista ka ngayon, nakapag-aktivit ka. Kung magpag-aktivit ka ngayon, may magiginibo ka ngayon para sa pagkino ng panawaan. Umulit ka ngayon dito sa nagata, ako na ngayon tulad ang ginibo mo. Siyempre po ako ba ang magbanda, all the while, ang nag-aram ko, talagang salang gobyerno, kaya ako nag-aktivista. Sabi niya sa kuya, hindi ang ganyan malinawan, mayo ngayon sa bukid ng laban. If you want to help change the community, the society, maglaon ka ngayon. Help from the inside. Ang tinawag mo sa topic mo niyan is about public service. Sabi ko, gabos man kami tuloy nasa public service eh. Diba? You, Jerry, is in public service. Iba nga lang, in-trip ka. Si Noli is also helping the community through sports. Kailan po pag sinabing public service kaya, ganun baga, Jerry, pag sinabing public service government, ano? Ganun baga kaya, pag sinabing COVID? Pag-pisika, ano po? Pag sinabing ngayon kape, this kape yan, ano? Kasi mga, kung pag sinabing mga public service, politika, malaw sa government. Well, it's not only through government that we can serve people. Isishare ko sa inyo muna sa mga realization ko kang nag-try ako for 3 years sa public service. Ano po? Inunungahin din ko naman that we really need to step up governance. Na lalo-lalo na po into things like streamlining ka mga proseso, automation ka mga proseso. Ano po? Ang pag-innovate. Kahit po baga, pag makakapag kita sa Manila, kaya overseas, we need to go to bayan there to place a call. Kapira ka, tapos malaw ka naman sa burubos na to. Pag Manila ang sayo ka ulit, medyo malinaw din ako. Pero pag ako na, naroon na sa iraro ng baga-baga yan. Pero mo niya mo, in just a span of less than 30 years, mas kisahin ka, pwede mo nang mapaulay at sa'yo mong gustong kaulay, true self mo. May hiling mo ba? Iba-iba na. But in governance, it's different. Si gobyerno ko at ko, sa gobyerno ko niyan, halos mayroon ko nagkaliba in terms of giving its services, frontline services, social services, ano po. Ibang-iba pa. So, there is really a need to do better than government style of doing business. Ang pinagpuruan ko rin sa governance is not about doing it the best possible way. Ang pinagpuruan ko rin sa governance is good governance. Doing it right pa lang. How to do it right? Bakong how to do it best. Bakong iyo po. Ang tinatawag ng palamunagal ng gagobyanong award ito, Seal of Good Local Governance. Step one lang, foundation. Ano po? So, dapat asikasuhan ko yan. Isipin mo dito ang pinagagamit na data ng ng gobyerno into budgeting its money or information that has been gathered at least 5 years ago. For the government to do things now, it should have been planned last year. Eh po. Kasi, halimbawa, si itinag mo niya na taon. Ano po? Munya na halimbawa, munya na 2018. Dapat may priorities sa mga 2017 pa. Ano dito ba? Procurement-wise, it takes about the very least. Budget muna. It will take you at least 1 month to do anything. Magpakal ka ng bulletin pa rin. It will take you 1 month. Not like the corporate one. Pag sinabi ka, implement na. Sige, let's do it. So, yung bagay na yun dapat pumunta. We need to change the way they operate the government. Just like what the private companies do. Dapat nag-acquire na siya. Pangalawa po, we should also change how we prioritize things. Ang nangyayari po tayo muna, when we let the leader, lalong-lalong at muna, kung ano ang nasa isip na namaray, sa hindi namaray, ito ang nangyayari. There is no better tool to hear what the people really want. Lalong-lalong at muna. Ang sa to yung mga presidente, sana nga malitin mo. I pay from the audio video. And nakaka-frustrate kasi po, the form of government that we have is a democratic form of government. But the way how we operate right now is all on a dictatorial government. So there should be a better tool to be able to engage people into governance. Better po muna medyo nagbabago na kasi we are mandated to have to consult civic organization within how we budget our money sa local government. Pero po, dapat mas hararo pa. Because it is only by that way that you can have the baseline data for what really the community needs. Then po iba-iba man ang need ng community. Halimbawa po, sa Naga, iba man ang Naga sa pili. Na, because ang Naga po on commercial, ang pili industrial. And iba ang pili sa Gatchitorena. Mga taga-Gatchitorena po kayo. May thing on federalism as ano as related to sa dapat tinatamuntang leader ang tao. As sabi ko lalo po, as a former local chief executive, lalo na po sabi ko, we should oppose federalism. As sabi ko lalo. Why? Sasabi ko sa'yo, hindi ang pro-federalism. Sabi na, magayon kasi mas madagula ang budget kan duga kasi is what you have is what you spend. Pero po, halag ka, ano ang nasa people para mag-generate nila ng pagkalap? Do we have a lot of industries here? Are we like Manila na talagang laon naman ang laban ng kwarta? We basically have nothing. We do not have a lot of mining companies here. We do not have a lot of manufacturing companies here. So ano po ang mawawala sa 22 sa people pag kita po nag-uyo sa federalism? How do we spend for education? How do we spend for infrastructure? Kasi po, 95% or almost all of the local governments here are ira-dependent. Gusto sabihin po, naghahalap kita kang dolna halik sa national government. So, practically po, losing entertainment dito. What is, I think, palatable for all of us sa Pilipinas is just to increase the share of the local government units coming from the national fund. Sa kasarungan po, why do we have to go federalism? Dahil kapangalit na perfect ng democracy, ma-federalism na kita, di ba? I think, ang salap ako sa form of government, which leads me to the third realization na pakuman si government per se ang salap si form. Ang kulang tapo are the good people who wants to sacrifice into entering governance. Ang pangatlo kong realization is that we need a lot of good people to really start to care and be leaders for our community. Tanda po nito na itong high school kita, garbage in, garbage out. We cannot expect good results from bad leaders, di ba? Kaya we need a lot of good leaders to really start caring for all of us. Ang nagbibigay po problema, alam ko ngayon ang politika at politika pa rin natin. But then again, we expect a lot of results from government, di ba? How can we get good results from bad leaders? How can we, right now, how can we start getting good economics from a president na talagang dinami niya na makakaroon sa ekonomiya? Tama si Derek, ang pagiging entrepreneur, dahil sa politiko, siguro, kung magkakaibang o iwan ang school for entrepreneurship, dapat magkaibang magkaroon school for politics. Bako lang full side. Siguro, there should be a move na magkaibangan din school for local governance. Nagiging problema ko kaya, pag halimbawa, ang job ng paglaw sa politika, pag naglaw ka naman, parehas ka na ng gabos. Pero kung siguro kung kadaan ng mga leaders na balay, somehow may iba po ang dynamics na ano po. Yan po ang dapat na mangyari. Democracy is good. Federalism may be good, but better if we have a lot of good people coming in as leaders sa Federal Government. On whether or not actually coming back to politics comes 2019, siguro po, tama kung sinabi ni Jerry na sa first time mapapasok ka. Siguro po, I'm not closing doors, ano. Pero kung kanapon akong mahilig nilalay na amigo na gusto naman maglaw sa politika, siguro magiging sa pagyari. Kumbawa si Noli, ha? Si Noli, si Jeff, ano po? Balikan ka po, actually kang mga ino, mas dahil pa magsabi sa ako si Noli dito na gusto niya magpolitika. Sana. Pero kung siguro ang magiging leader sa community, it's more of faith. Siguro, day mo aram, one day, ma-tolman sa iyo na, ewa akong kaya. Ewa akong mag-sacrificio. Bako kong pauma, sa totoo lang, it's all work. Ano? Natatandaan ko kung nasa politika pa kung pipistorya ko nani na pag matamo gawa na mga tao kung ano ang pagkahagan everything that you can imagine pagpagulot ng buho pag nasulot pa si buho pagpa-treat girarin ng buho yung pang-birthday. Sabi ko nga nyo sa opening siya ako, pag may nag-birthday sa kuya, sabi ko, anong niya ko nagdidigap para hindi tara na? Pag-inom na ako. Ipag nakikihagad sa kuya ng tabang, paulay mo, pasunduhan ko siya. Sirisimana po, may patul. Sabi ko, kang medyo rin na sabi ko, pwede daw niya kung pang businessman lang sa mula. Kung niya ko pang mga kong mga empleyado, ang businessman lang nagsuswindo sa mula. Kaya nga sabi ako, ano niya ko? Pag madalan ang araw kong mahata, ano niya ko? Kung ano muna naman sa pasahin mo sa kuya. Since then. But because, nangyayari po yan because, si presenting kultura ng politika is out of there. We really have to change that. Ano po? Hanggang dahil nagbaba po ang kultura ng pag-ulit ng tao sa politika, we can never really advance as a movement. Whether it be federalism or democracy. They will come up. As long as we let the bad people most of the bad people are not the government. There would be no better public service. Sa Ateneo po, pinuntukan kita, nagkagpit sa Tuhan, to be meant for others. And sa inyo po, ang pinaka, sa important is to be able to hold leaders to having that culture of, or attitude of being meant for others. Bago po maglawag sa politika or public service sa daring advancement, hindi po, to really help to have a better community through being meant for others. Thank you very much.
I'm very happy that I am standing here together with my batchmates and of course kay Nonoy sa kay Bidoy. Individuals who I consider ma'am po grade 1 hanggang si Nonoy hanggang college sa UP kay Bad Amigaya. I had the opportunity to work with Bidoy sa student council sa Kitayapa sa high school. With Nonoy when we were in college sa UPLB. Naging mayor nga ni Simon. And you know, I'm following both of them in social media. That's the only time you can only follow each other nowadays. Seeing how they move the world through what they do, it fills me with pride even if I'm in the third land. Kaya yung grupo mga kato si Simon ay magkaiba na kami sa org. Itong mga matakal, magimik kami sabay ng bambi. Uubusog niyang kwartami. Magkikiturog ako sa harap niya, sa mama na kami, grabe ang gober, kami na aga. Kay buwan ni magtipid, mahapon siya, ang oras na nun, alas 9, turugan ka pa niya para makatipid kitang breakfast. Iturog na hanggang lunch. Yung gigimulang yung pag-lunch, malakaw kami maluwas, makikikakal kami sa harap ng saluming brand na within the same subdivision. And I'm just so happy that at this moment we are actually sharing our ideas to you. Nagtutulog ako na nabula ako ng iniing pinupunan ng kultura kini sa magiging larangan kang homecoming ka Ateneo. In fact, perhaps if this will become something that will elevate the way homecoming is being done in Ateneo de Naga, then I think it would be a homecoming that will cater to a lot of different alumni. Not just the homecoming on the 30th, but the homecoming collective ideas. My topic is sports engineering, and when it was published ni Carl, may mga nag-message ako sa Facebook, what is sports engineering? Gusto ko po sa inyong paliwanag kung taano nakaabot yan sa sports engineering. When Carl initially created the social media poster, akalagat-akalag naman, Jerry Ilao, entrepreneurship, Noli San Luis, public service, Noli Ayo, sports and culture building. Doang linyang gayo ang kinakan ko. So sabi ko, masukog ba na iksalaro linya lang? Sa kuya, doang linya. So sabi ko, paano? Alabawang ini. So, may muna ako nagko-COVID kay Carl. And pero may deadline ito eh. Nagkataon, it was a Sunday. I just came from a workshop on a Saturday with our coaches. Si Carl, mga mid-morning ini, mga alas 9, nag-message ulit siya, is this okay? Sabi niya, kasi halawin talaga ko sports and culture building, a little bit off if it's in a poster. Halawin siya. I was reading an email sent by a young coach. Yung young coach na niya, is a graduate of Ateneo de Naga, chemical engineering. Pasado siya ng chemical engineering. Ang message na niya, halawin ko nito, sinabi niya lang na, he is making a decision to give up his first 2 years so that he can become a coach for the Netherlands. Sinabi niya duman, and this is where that engineering came in. I was in that spot na Coach Noli. Kasi sinabi niya, Coach Noli, I am very thankful that you re-engineered my mind. Yawa ako sa part na to, kung binabasa ko itong message ni Carl. And then pag sabi niya, sabi ko, Carl, kasi pag sinabing sports engineering, eksakto. Sabi niya, what the hell is sports engineering? That engineering part triggered me. And in fact, it made me reflect that, oh, sabi niya, there has to be more engineering in the field of sports, and not only in the field of sports, but in whatever fields we are in. May it be in government service, may it be in business, may it be in whatever we do, even in family. I'm sure for those, there's so much engineering involved. And I'll share to you that engineering side by first sharing two stories about what I had the privilege of going through as a coach. Most of you know me, I'm a coach. In fact, I think that's the way it's gonna go. I'll be a coach. This was taken 10 years ago here in Naga. This is Joe Macalandria, now a coach for Naga Science High School. This is John Miquilio, now an engineer for SMART. This is Julius Vargas, he's based abroad overseas. This is Joshua Isoy, also an engineer for San Miguel. Pinili ko yan because for those of you who's asked na nag-aral ang background ka Ateneo de Naga, dati makita ang scholarship niya, and gusto ko marami ito when I was growing up. When we were growing up, Jeremy Ilao was the best basketball player. Not only in our batch, but feeling ko even a batch younger or a batch higher, next only to Alvin Alvarez. Kasi si Alvin is batch 94. I think to me, growing up, Alvin Alvarez, batch 94, was one of the gifted basketball players. But next to us, Jerry Ilao, the parang sa mga MGL, ito mga first year kita, aharap ko doon. Ako si Dave. Kapusog lang ang MGL 16 si Dave. Kapusog lang ito MGL 16. Ang pinili inahapot ka ko, makawat ba si Dave? Makawat si Dave. Kasi kung magkawat si Dave, mo kayo. Pag di magkawat, may laman kita. Okay, sa LG ko yan. Talagang may laman kita. That's how Binoy was. I'm very happy that Jack is here, caretakers in the Sindaka basketball program. When Jack showed me that we have a budget that's like this, a culture that Nona has been sharing, I don't know how to do it. It was started because, I believe, because of this four individuals. But I had the opportunity to connect. Always, ang nabibis to dyan, pag nagkakano, you should be the old person who's coaching the team. But to me, honestly, I'm just blessed to have met these four individuals and other individuals as well, but in yung mga game changer. 2007, they say, we started winning, then things happened better. Ang Naga City Gym, kung nakadaman yun yan, that's only 400 lang ang kasya dyan. Kanto, pag nagkakawa ng Ateneo, di man yan pinapano. Ang mga dalalan lang dyan, si mga ilusyon, mga kaklase, mga kapamilya, and si Don Razon. Don Razon was then with SDI, he would just show up, watch the game. That's how we became friends, because he would show up regularly. Who's this person in my classes? Kagil Masini, may daradarang popcorn, ito nababakal sa luwas. Tapos, naglalaat sa plastic na juice or soft drinks, madali. Then ito napapalo. Then, we started winning, not just winning, but winning with a little bit of statement. Because these kids showed up. John Miquilio, the one to my right, was recruited by De La Salle University, Franz Pumare, in 2006. This was in 2007. In 2006, he was recruited. We played against De La Salle in the Father Martin Cup. He scored 21 points in the fourth quarter. Against T.Y. Tang, J.P. Casio, Nico Mayo for that batch. We lost by 33 points to De La Salle. But what scared me was after the game, Jacques Santiago, the lead assistant of Franz Pumare, and still is the lead assistant of Franz in Alonso, approached me and said, Coach, interesado si Coach Franz Barano. If you like, we can invite him. Mayo pang team din si Franz Pumare kato. Meaning, pag nirecruit niya, dao. Kan 2006, ayun pa ni si ganador si Franz Pumare, dito basketball, ano siya, very, marami pa katugan, very successful siya madala sa program. And, ano ang pinagkong sinabi ka to Jack? Ang nasa isip ko, hindi ko, araw ko nasabi ko ni ka Jack, magkaibanan kami kami sa Father Martin Cup, hindi ko na lang sabi yung ni Jack. Kasi kung hindi naman aram, hindi okay lang. Pero I believe I have the responsibility as the coach to tell the kid. So, a few days after, I talked to Jack. No, yung nililigod ka kung nasaan. Ang purpose nito yung pagkuman sa Father Martin Cup ng 2006 is para manggana sa naga. Imagine mo na lang na pagkuman means yung pinakamaray kong player pagdaling ko, ora! So I was really scared na ito din dati. Yun ang sabi niya sa ko, coach, pag-isipan ko. So pagkatapos nito, a few days before we left, nagbalik siya, coach, I'll stay with Ateneo. Natanda ko yung sinabi niya, sabay kitang nangarap, napapakarayong na niya, hopefully matapos na nga. And that's why whenever I would speak in front of people, I would always mention the name of John Bikini. In the same way that I would mention the name of Jeff, because kung maliling yung dumakinig na guro na tubod sa ko, siguro na yung magiging bukini para sa Ateneo de Naga. But going back to the story, in 2006, pagbalik niya, ang gana against UNC, sinabi niya that Champa, yung isang 2007 picture na nag-back-to-back. Why did I share this? Because this is very instrumental. In this series, nag-galan si Father Tabora. And if you know Father Tabora, he doesn't believe in sports. Especially to give scholarship for sports. If you're gonna give scholarship, might as well give it to academics. Funny because the reason why I'm in Davao is because of Father Tabora and sports. And that's another story. But nag-galan si Father Joel. Sa game na yan, sa series na yan, we pushed UNC to third game, to three games, and then actually won the third game by 25 points, with John McKinney scoring 33 points in the final game. There were three questions that changed the outcome of Ateneo basketball, Ateneo de Naga basketball, perhaps also the culture of sports in Ateneo de Naga, and whether we admit it or not, even the culture of sports of Naga College, who is now the winningest team now in Naga. They also qualified for the first time. Ang Naga may nag-qualify na team sa national championship na kalaob ang Naga College sa Elite 8 by beating the champion team of North Luzon, first time. Ano ko yung sinabi ko sa mental kita? Because when Naga College was losing to us, I would meet up with Wesley Villanueva, the head coach there, and tell him not to give up. Keep on doing this. This is how we win in Ateneo. Do this, do this, do this. Why was I doing that? Because you've heard of iron sharpens iron. You know? I believe that if we create more good people around us, more people who loves would believe in the same passion as you, it will give you more hope that perhaps what you're doing is right, is true. So see, Father Joel nagdalan kanin. Game 1, nagkakita. Game 2, si Bikilio dapat temaan din. Taano, may exam. Ba, engineering, full day exam. Sabi ko, ito, full day. Ito pala, it's an annual thing, battery test. Araw mo mga players ko na pag may exam, you don't go to the game. Eh, nadalan siya ng game 1 ni Bade. So, pag game 2, narisan ba yun siya? So, the first question is, hindi ni Father Tabora. Where is number 15? This was 3 p.m. Ang exam niya nagpuon, 8 a.m. Where was number? Is number 15? And it's a holiday, tama. And then it was a holiday. Inuman ko na ganyan. Holiday ito. So, pinahapot. Tandaan ko ito. May nagdalakan sa buya, ni Jay, nagahapot. Nasa ito na yan si Bikilio. Of course, sinabi ko, may exam. Balik. Question number 1, where is number 15? Came automatic after that, the question number 2. What's question number 2? Who is the teacher? Who is the teacher? And it, you know, very instrumental to me because nag-feeling ko, natanyog na si Father naman. Si pinanginig ko ganyan ang sports lang yan. Nagpa-ayo si number 15. Who's the teacher? And bistado na po itong teacher na ito. Padangan na ito sa batch. Younger to sa ito. Bistado na ito. Sa tango ko siya sa pangalan. Kasi si teacher ko si Zero, mga nyo. Padangan ko rin nga. Sa batch na, bisado na si Zero. Inapodan, ano sabi lang ng father? I want Bikilio, tumingin na lang si Bikilio. Aray na lang si Bikilio, nagpakasakay, aray na si uniform. Nag-abot sa second quarter, but of course we lost the game. Because dahil siya nakapuon, mga nalang, sa kondisyon. Masa sa kondisyon na magkawa. Third game, we won. Father Joel asked, "Where are you guys going? We're gonna have our team dinner in San Jose, Bonino Green." Sabi niya, "Can I join you? Can you join us?" And then I told, I introduced him to the team. And then, sinabi ko, I don't think, I was just lucky enough na makadugtong ko yung mga tao. And then of course, the third question came, the most important question ko. Noli, how can I help? It's the most important question. But feeling ko, the third question would not have came out if the first two questions didn't prepare it. Of course, I only asked for two things. Scholarship and the gym. People would say the gymnasium was reconstructed because of PE. It was really reconstructed so that we can practice well. So that's 2007. 10 years after, 2017, this is me in Davao with my brothers, our brothers and sisters from Ilao. Paul Domingos from General Santos, myself from Davao, Joseph Layao from Marawi, Paula Salvador from Davao, Simone Haldon from Davao, Chidel San Diego from Ozami City. The next to him is Arvin Martinez from Cagayan de Oro. Next is Al Rashid Sendad from Maguindanao. And last is Vincent Vanilla from Cagayan de Oro. This is the first time that a small group of leaders went out of the country, not relying on government, to actually learn how to become better leaders. This is in Singapore Sports School. High school unit in Singapore na focus sports and academics. And the facilities there is a better version of our Philippine Sports Commission. Of our Philippine Sports Commission is only a high school facility in Singapore. Ano po that we share with you? In Mindanao, it's also the same thing, but that's happened. I am now, what I'm doing now is, I'm the athletics director in Ateneo de Naga, but I'm also involved in the Mindanao Peace Games. It's and that's why, sabi niya, it's, should we put games? Tama ka doon, nagkakaproblema ko sa word na games, kasi pag sinabi games, karawat lang. And what we do in the Mindanao Peace Games, games is just part of it. That's why we sometimes resort to MPG, because it's better that way. Na isa na kakamun na games. But anyway, we are investing on leadership. Leadership in through sports. So, perfect present ko ini sa mga kaibanan. Pakala nyo na, bakit kaya ba natin lumabas? My friends from the NSA, the National Sports Association, asked me, so tumulong ba sa inyo ang Philippine Sports Commission? It's a smart help, and then we were able to pull resources from our schools and we were able to bring them up. So this is what this is 10 years after that, this is the Mindanao Peace Games. So where's the engineering in all that? Babalikan ko kanina, it was triggered by the word re-engineering. Sports is engineering because engineering needs competent people. It needs competent and dedicated people. Sports needs that too. And you, of course, if you're not just sports, if in anything you do, if you don't have the competent people, the dedicated people, medyo masakit mo. Masakit ka maka-blaze ng trail, masakit ka maka-create ng mark. Engineering needs competent and dedicated people. In sports, we are thirsty for that. Sometimes, when I arrived in Davao, ang akala ng mga taga-Davao is, bakit yan pumunta dito? We can always be an athletics director. Of course, because Father Joel, the desire of Father Joel is really to, sabi niya sa akin po, bago kami naglipat, hindi ko manakalaman na matugod si Trish. Noli, I want you to do only two things in Mindanao. One, coach our basketball team in Davao, and coach it the way you did in Naga, and then create a Mindanao-wide tournament. I thought I can do both. But then I realized when I went to Davao, I gave so much to Ateneo de Naga as a coach that I cannot give it again to Davao. I've given so much for Naga as a coach that wala akong may lumabas sa Davao as a coach. But then as a leader, igwa ka. So sports is engineering because it needs competent and dedicated people. Second, sports is engineering because engineering, if you look at it by definition, you have to create systems to make it easy. I realized that it's not just a matter of connecting people. It's also very important that you connect the right people. Minensyo ni Nonoy kasi bago. Masakit sa politika mo niyan is kasi pag naglaon ka, kakakanoon ka talaga, kakanakulong ng pare-pareho. Daw ang grabe ang kainianisin mo, pwede ka talaga kakanoon unless may mahilig ka naman sa uwara yung nagdaon. Parang yung kini. Magdugot ka. Yun ang sinabi ko kay Raynor sa kasi Jody Kasubago, yung hindsight lang. Pag abot ko sa Mindanao, sabi, masakit ko kayo kakadamon ng tao naman, iba-iba na kami. Pero sabi ko, na-realize naman, since dapon na tao, baka dapon man kami pare-pareho. And these are my fellow kindred in the world. And of course, again, sports is engineering because we need dedicated and competent people. Sports is engineering because we need to connect the right people. And this is the last. Sports is engineering because it's very, very important that we have a solid base. A solid base. In a structural engineering framework, a solid base is very, very important. And this is where the culture will come in. Bidoy, with this passion for entrepreneurships, it's going around the country, not only around the country, but outside the country. It's about setting a base that is healthy enough na pag naglaob duman, ang dawag ba kung matibay? Matibay. Tapos ang maglaob duman at maluya, pag di siya nagbago, iluluwak siya. So mamimili mong ginaray, si Maray. And that's why, I'd like to end it with this, 2011. This is the final image I will have of my final year of coaching in Ateneo de Naga. Ah, sorry, in my last championship as a coach for Ateneo de Naga. This was 2011. Tandaan niyo, this is in the Robredo Coliseum that can fit 5,000 people. I told you, we started in Naga City Gym in 2007 that can only fit 800 people. This is the crowd. Bakupok niyo, Araneta. Bakup ni Moa, bakup ni Ateneo na babasa ng Dom de Manila. This is our Ateneo de Naga. They followed us. Sports is engineering because it means a good culture. In whatever we do, there's a lesson in sports that we can learn. We need good and competent people. We need to connect the right people. And last, create a solid base. Nadawak na magpara rami pagpagabot na problema. Pag nagbabalik ka naman, I think this is the one. Pag nagbabalik ka naman, it would be humility, it would be enforcing, it would be charged. Salamat.